Having spent the last few years being bankrupt, how does it feel now not to owe the world a cent?
Well, I actually was discharged from bankruptcy over a year ago. As far as I'm concerned, I've never owed the world anything. I come from a part of the world where people don't welch on their debts. And as I was meant to have debts, they were all paid, weren't they?
You were discharged from being a bankrupt. You owed about £130,000. It's a lot of money in anybody's terms. How do you actually start paying it off?
Well, you go around with the app. Now, what you do is, in my instance, it was easy because they were safeguarded in terms of my performance royalties. So, you know, every time one of my songs gets played on the radio or the TV, anywhere in the world, it went straight to the receivers. And so they were guaranteed that they would all get paid back in total, in any case, if they wanted to wait long enough, which was 3 years in this instance. And, in fact, during that 3 years, if I'd wanted to do anything, I wouldn't have got a cent for it. It would have had to gone straight to the receivers. So, I just lived on with a little help from my friends and did some work, which I'm putting about now.
But you spent years writing songs for everybody else, and I know you've got a fairly new departure, haven't you? You've written a song for yourself.
Well, I wrote a song about, I'm always writing songs, you see. Somebody just came out to my place and was talking on about what they had and didn't have, and I just had the tape going and I wrote a song called Don't Talk About It, Lay It on the Table. And some friends of mine, Herbie Flowers, who's a great bass player, came in and said, well, you've got to record that. And then I recorded it and I put my song Living Doll on the back. That was the song I wrote for Cliff Richards a long time ago. Early rock and roll, except I sing it as a lullaby. But Don't Talk About It on the Table was played around to various record labels and they didn't realise it was me. Well, when they found out it was me, they decided to sign me up on a 5-year recording deal as an artist. But as you know, that is not my main function
So you're now a songwriter turned artist. I know you're singing along with a song. Do you enjoy being a singer rather than a songwriter?
Well, I am a performer really, except that I just don't like doing it more than one night running. More than two consecutive performances. Joan Littlewood has always called me a clown, and basically I am. But I tend to write for other artists and other characters and other situations. Basically, my intention is to direct movies. At the moment, I'm very much involved in doing a double album of an opera that I wrote 12 years ago called Quasimodo.
And you're also, I believe, got a new musical coming out, haven't you?
Yes, there's a musical I wrote about Golda Meir when she was a little girl, which I believe is opening in New York. And also there's a show opening in May here in London, which is about me. I think it's called Lie, or Lionel Bart, maybe. I don't know what it's called.
And it's a bit of a history of you.
Well, sort of. There's a little kid called Lie, and I'm the kid. But other than that, there's about 30 of my songs. And there's Everybody's Yiddish and Mama, there's Everybody's Whore with a Heart of Gold, and there's Everybody's Fade Out. And there's everybody's, all reflections of people I've seen and sung and written for, people that have inspired me, you know?
Lionel Bart, you're obviously a very busy man. Thank you very much.
Well, thank you.